day.
The area for the show is the Barbados Rally Club stand, which has got Sol Rally Barbados memorabilia on sale and loads of copies of the official programme for the event, which has got the all-important safety messages in it. Quite some time ago, we put the programme to bed just before the media briefing, which was back on April the 9th. So there have been one or two changes to the entry list, and if you can bear to listen to me tomorrow as well as today, and obviously all over next weekend, I'll be updating you with the things on the entry list that have changed. Thankfully, very few of the changes on the entry list are people who are not here. It's rather more one or two changes of class, one or two changes of co-driver. But we are going to be starting 89 cars in Flow King of the Hill tomorrow. It's the third highest entry we've ever started, and Sol Rally Barbados next weekend will be 91. Again, very close to the record number that we have had in the past. So two amazing weekends of competition. Important to our overseas visitors, of which for the fourth year in a row we are welcoming more than 40 overseas crews from not only around the wider Caribbean, but also from the UK, from Ireland, and all the way from New Zealand as well. This time we've got three cars entered by members of the extended Marshall family. Mike Marshall, legendary Kiwi rally driver, winner of Rally New Zealand back in the mid-70s. As well as the Barbados Rally Club selling its merchandise and giving away the official programme. Also, incidentally, if you are here from the media and didn't read to the end of the "this is where you sign on for your media pass" note that I sent out the other day, that's also in the top right-hand corner.
Showground, if you are facing.
backing stage, who haven't I mentioned yet? Massey Realty, they're here with Calvin Briggs and his Sky and Terra Caribbean tents, almost directly opposite the main stage.
Not that right. had some. And we had a problem with it. So we've got this new pot I own.
Tomorrow from the Barbados Rally Club tent, which is, if you are looking directly at the stage, the one in the top right-hand corner of the showground. Mr. Weir and Mr. Weir, welcome. Good to see you both. Mr. McKay. We've also got, there's the football competition over at diagonally, right over the far corner of the showground from the Barbados Rally Club. Okay, you're a boy driver, but you have to be part of the lady co-drivers group for a moment. I thought we'd start with some girls. For the girls. Yeah, all right, don't go mad. They'll just get big-headed. Do you want to sit one either side of me? How would that work? So, wrong way round, because it isn't a left-hand drive car. But I've got the driver on my left and the co-driver on my right. She's only a short one, you see, so getting up onto the tall steps is a bit hard. It's a bit wobbly. Yeah, well, you know, you get what you pay for, don't you, really? Now then, does the other microphone work? Say hello.
Hello.
Oh, it works. That's good. This is Shelley Taunt to my left. I'll hold on to your keys so they don't blow out. Put them under my little paper tip there. Third time, yes?
Yep, third time lucky.
Well, actually, no, that's not strictly true, because first time was hugely unlucky.
It was.
The piece of Barbados leapt out at you.
It did. It was a bank. It wasn't there when we did the recce, but it was there.
It had been there for 14,000 years, but on the day you did the recce, it was sort of absent.
Yes. So that was the first year, and then the second year was 2016, and the gear stick broke in half in my hand.
But you're only a little person, so you need a short gear stick, surely.
Yeah, but I'm like Popeye, I've got
big. I'm like Popeye, I've got big. Okay, well, we'll move rapidly on at this point, I think. So here you are back for a third time. Which car have you got here, Doris or Bill? I can't remember what your cars are called.
Tilly today. Tilly the tarmac.
Tilly car.
Tarmac, yeah.
Yeah, right. So and all is well? Scrutineering went well?
Yeah, it went well. That was the first time I sat in it for 2 years.
Right, now this is the complicated bit, isn't it? Because you went home from Sol Rally Barbados 2016 and sort of stopped rallying.
Yeah, we just built a house. So
you built a house?
Built a house, so we stopped rallying for 2 years. And then,
actually, Gordon, who's her other half, does this sort of house building stuff. And what they do is they park a couple of rally cars and a road car side by side and say, okay, well, that's the garage then. Where are we going to put the rest? That's sort of roughly how it works, isn't it?
We built the garage first for the rally cars and then build the house a bit later on.
Believe me, I am not making this up, as they say. So, the other thing that's happened, just a little bit of background, she's not the first person in her family to be involved in rallying. Her father, who is a man of advanced years, must be in three figures by now, mustn't he, Taunty, really?
Almost.
David ran a rally school called the Silverstone Rally School, very close to the home of the British Grand Prix in the middle of England, and was a safety car driver, among other things, for many years, lots of events I was involved in, right up to World Championship level. And he sort of was very supportive, wasn't he, always, of your rallying?
Well, I didn't have any choice when I was there at all. I just got dragged around, around the country on rallies and thrown in the back of rally cars and...
Because your mother's as bad as your dad, really, isn't she, in terms of this sort of rallying thing?
Yeah.
You know, the point of the story is, as they say, Shelley arrived on Thursday. With the rest of the gang, and walked into...
Infinity on the beach,
where they are staying. That is Infinity on the beach. And there, standing at the bar... Actually, not making much use of it because it was election day and it was before 6 o'clock.
were her mum and dad, and she thought they were in
Gran Canaria.
In Gran Canaria, which, and I've heard of people going to airports and getting on the wrong flight, but that is a bit of a stretch, isn't it?
So no idea.
And well chuffed, I hope.
Yeah, big surprise. Dad's been on about, well, obviously the last two times we've been to Barbados, he's desperately wanted to come with us. And, you know, for reasons couldn't. So, yeah, lovely surprise to see him out here.
So where are the dogs?
At home.
At home?
At home with my son.
Oh, I see. So Stefan stayed at home?
Yes, he did.
How much do you think his grandfather bribed him to do the staying at home and looking after the dogs bit?
I'm not sure who bribed who.
I'm worried.
Now then, I'm going to pass the microphone over to Julie. Julie's the organised one.
Am I?
You are. Julie Murphy, the co-driver. Julie has been reading road books now for about a week or a month. There's a Facebook group of European crews, and they all sort of ask one another questions. The first person every year to say, when's the route coming out then, nag, 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 is Ms. Murphy here.
I like to be organised.
Do you have to be organised when you're sitting next to her?
I do. I have to be quite bossy.
How long is it now, you two together?
About 14 years.
Neither of you look old enough for that. How am I doing?
All right.
I'm doing all right, am I?
Yeah, I was about two when I started.
Yes, you're a kindergarten co-driver. Co-driver beginning with a K, it would be quite fun. So, you've won championships together, and not just girly championships, you've won proper championships against the boys as well.
We have indeed, yeah.
And you run a driving school as well, don't you?
I do.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I must be mad, really.
Yes, you must, because your image and your reputation relies on you, in this particular instance, not being the person holding onto the steering wheel.
Yes.
So when pieces of age-old Barbados leap out of nowhere, it's not your fault, really, is it?
No.
But you have to explain that to people.
Yes.
So, aspirations for this year? Where did you finish overall last time with your broken gearbox? Lever. Oh, yes, that's a clever girl. I'm a bit of a beginner at this microphone thing, you see.
I think we finished 45th, I think.
Right, so you want to be...
We took a stage maximum on the Saturday night, on stage 14.
Right.
Stage maximum, so it dropped us right at the back.
So apart from your own age, in Rally Barbados, you want to be in your 30s again.
That would be lovely.
That would be nice, wouldn't it?
Lovely, yes. If we could get inside the top 30, we'd be happy with that.
Good. Well, good luck to both of you. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, Julie Murphy to my right and Shelley Tall to my left. You want crane and equipment to come and help you down? You'd like a ladder. You're not wearing... My wife used to hula hoop, but that was a very long time ago, before she met me, essentially. So I know that we are shortly going to be regaled by some pipe music from some of the visitors.
Bring some conversation to always come. Sure,
what you want, we are both.
Hands up high. This is something that's hard, but we have it.
Really nice. This is nice though, Harold.
I sat next to Ryan Champion, both of us with microphones in our hands, was at Wales Rally GB last year, doesn't it?
Yes, commentating on some affectionately named cars.
Affectionately, we won't do that here.
By a friend of ours, but yeah, we were commentating on the spectator stage on Wales Rally GB.
Weren't we? Did we have fun?
We did. But it wasn't quite as warm as this, I don't know.
It wasn't, was it? They have this sort of thing called either Slowly Sideways or whatever, which is a collection of people who've got nice historic rally cars. Now, Ryan's been around a long time. His mum and dad have been involved in rallying for donkeys. I've been around for longer, actually probably than mum. Well, no, mum and dad and I...
I'll tell you what it's like.
Yeah.